Hello everybody, welcome to your new session. In this session we are going to discuss about how to use a table in the form of example. A table in the form of example, I mean to say that when I have a requirement to pass so many data to a particular field or particular page and fill the form, I need that data basically. So how I can use that from the table? You can see this is a form of table we are passing into the cucumber, okay? But I want to execute this test scenario based on my row number. Okay, so when the test execute this whole scenario execute first time, it will take the data from this row. When second time it execute, it will take the data from this row. When third time, this row, and keep on continuing as many data if you pass and as many row if you add. Now this can be achieved in different way also. Like I can pass the examples, put all these data here, and then write, like I can map the data like name and name, title and title, ID and ID, and company and company. I can do it, but I can do this way also. Now why I'm doing this way, there is a reason behind that. Suppose I want to pass the data to one form, I'm filling a form, but the same form I want to fill it 10 times. I want to fill 10 times with 10 different set of data. So all my scenario steps should execute. So when the first time this scenario execute, it will start from here, then it will execute here, it will take data from here, then it will execute and finish it. Second time it will execute, all this is execute, then take the data like this. Okay. Why I'm doing it? Because I need to pass some 25 set of data. Okay. So to pass the 25 set of data, I need to write like fill the form, name and title and email ID and company and blah 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 blah, and keep on going, right? And I have to map with the example. I need to put the here also the column name, and I have to map it. Okay, but I want to avoid that mapping. I want to pass in the form of table. Okay, now how I'm reading this data into the step definition, I'll show you. Now when the each column is basically a key and each data is a value. So one row and like default row on the top column and this is a value. Then again default column and this is a value. So I can treat as a map. So many time data is there. So each row is a list. So list of map, I can do it. Okay. So I'm reading the data in the form of list of map. Okay. What I did, sorry, I executed. I need to go to the steps, find steps. Okay, now you can see it. I'm reading the data in the form of, see, data table dot as maps string of string, and reading into the form of list. So list of map. So when I'm reading, as you know, I'm getting the row number. The first time in the data I'm reading, first time when whole scenario is running, I'm getting the zero as a column. So I'm putting as a list of zero, get this key name. Similar to that, I can put title also, zero and then title. Let me get the what I have given, title, same title. Okay, I can take it, title, correct. Similar to that, if I go here, I can take other fields also like company. So where we can use it, there are multiple way of using it. Like suppose you want to check the negative scenario. Negative scenario means if the fields are mandatory or not. In place of doing this example, you just remove the example. You can use this whole data table and fill the form and keep on clicking. With a different set of data, you can do it. That also you can use it because you're reading in the form of map, list of map. You pass one list, whole set of data, click, get the error, validate the error, again do. So you will decide in the same step also. That also can do it. In the same step, you're testing whole scenarios and then coming out after that and you're testing it. I mean to say, for this step, you're testing all the set of data, different set of data. Somewhere you're passing the character, somewhere you're passing the integer, somewhere you're passing as a null, somewhere you're passing as a blank. Okay, so that also you can achieve this with the data table. So let's go what we have done it. So this, now when I run it, you see I'll run it with the help of a runner class. So I'll put it here. The different purposes are there. So if you know how to get the data, all data, I can put hundreds set of data there directly. So all will work. Just I'm opening the browser each time just to test it as executions are happening or not. Each time I'm opening and closing the browser, opening and closing the browser. So you see all set of data it has done. Now need to check it whether really all the data has printed or not from the map. You see Gupta, Prakash, Gupta, ABCD. Then here also Vijay, Gupta, ABCD, company name. Then here also Manmohan, Gupta, and the ABCD company name. So all data I have got it 4 times. You can see it. So this is a way you can use your data table in the Cucumber. You can pass as a data table in place of passing as an example also. Now why I have used these things, you can read the data from the Excel also. Now you'll ask how I can read the data from the Excel. Now suppose from the Excel you want to read some 10 row of data. You just pass 10 row and pass 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 each time it run. So when the moment it get the row number as 0, it will read the data from the 0 column, 0 row. So it will read the data from 0 row. So that way also you can use it. There are multiple purpose of this scenarios. That's the reason I chosen this scenario. You can pass the row number in place of not, don't pass this data, directly pass row number of the Excel. Directly say take the data from the Excel row number 0, 1, 2, then 10. So the test will run 10 times and take the data from the Excel 10 times. For that you have to write the code for reading the data, but you know the which row I have to read the data. If you want 20 times this scenario to execute from the Excel, you can run 20 times this scenario from the Excel. Just passing the Excel row number from here. Thanks for watching this video. Hope this will help you.